What's occurring, Benjamin?
Oh, well, I've just been sat here thinking how wonderful it is to have Melanie back on Ramsey Street.
In fact, we're going to call this the Neighbours for this episode in honour of Melanie.
The name else has got a ring to it.
So, I'm Mel.
I'm Mel. I'm not Madame Zolga.
Isn't it great? Isn't she just lighting up our screens
Enchantée. Yeah.
from every single moment that she just walks into the scene? She just brings with her this energy that is just infectious.
Sweetie treaties for the stinky little fadies.
Let me see if I can read your aura.
Hey there, Tiger.
I slept with Paul Robinson. Way back.
How squishy is that tushy?
What I love is it was a bit of a risk bringing back such a character from like the 80s, 90s to the show and bringing her back true to the character that she was.
Guess she hasn't really changed.
No, not at all.
And not changing it to kind of fit what Neighbours is now, which is like, unmissable drama.
Set, go!
Give me one of Melanie's picks any day of the week.
This is Bristow. I am leaving him with you. He likes to be in the action, and he'll remind you of me when I'm not here.
So she's come back true to the character that she was, and what's great is she's kind of fitted in to the cast so easily, and almost she's brought with her something that's been missing from Neighbours for months, for years.
What the laugh?
No, nothing. I just I must be hearing things.
And Melanie, we're not doing it like Yashvi and Mackenzie. We are doing it out of pure love.
All that spiteful little Nell either.
Oh, yes.
Like your granny either, like that spiteful little Nell.
Granny, 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 granny,
all right,
granny,
that's
granny,
it.
granny.
I know, in fact, but although Melanie is a granny, really, because Skye's got kids, so she technically is step-nan Mangle.
Granny.
Well, that's one tiny, tiny little bugbear I've got is that I remember when Skye came back, she made a comment that Melanie left when she was quite young and she doesn't really know her. I remember. I will hunt that clip down.
Mel has been through this before with Joe's kids, and well, she was a wonderful presence in their lives. I'm sure she will be with Nell and Hugo as well.
I'm sure you're missing Melanie as well.
I was only 5 when Dad and Mel divorced. I hardly remember her.
Oh.
Happy?
She's just brought back some of that classic Neighbours feel to the show, and it doesn't feel out of place. It just enhances our experience of the show.
And she's fitted in really nicely in the community as well, like all that business with Mrs. Punt and the horse poo.
She is not responsible.
Then who is?
I am.
When she was having that one-to-one with Dippy, as Dippy was about to leave, being that shoulder to cry on.
I could tell you the story of my tragic divorce if it makes you feel better. Although maybe another time. Over a glass of wine, perhaps. I'd like that.
A friendship with Amy as well. They've gelled really well.
Didn't this catch you, Tavira?
Yes, and it was wrong. What's the problem? I am sensing a man.
And also Roxy as well. Like Roxy made some really cool comments, like that she wanted to get to know her and everything. I thought, cute.
I've been meaning to get to know her. She seems fun in a Looney Tunes kind of way.
And what's surprising is her and Toadie.
I know.
So. Girlfriend, huh?
Yes.
Like, at first I was like, nah, they're better off as friends.
For the record, I don't do fire signs.
Right.
But as it's evolved, And it's become apparent it's not just like a story of the week for Toadie. It's actually kind of more of a long-term story. And that, as that's evolved, I'm with it. I'm on board. I support Toadie and Melanie.
Yeah, so do I.
And in case you hadn't noticed, my kids are a little bit obsessed with you.
And what about their dad?
Ah, well, he is a little obsessed with you too.
And also there's so much more to explore, because I can't wait for Melanie to just like be chatting to Ned and drop a bomb about, you know, her knowing Pam and Doug.
I really love what you've done to this place.
I've done a thing but moved in.
And in a nice sitting room into a disaster area.
No, I think it looks absolutely fantastic.
You know, Nana Pam and Grandad Doug.
What, all of them?
You know, she's got so much history with the show as well.
Yeah, I've forgotten about that. They haven't kind of connected the dots there, and there's much more to explore.
I could tell you all the gossip about Paul in the early days. It could be a real girl fest.
Definitely, definitely. And I can't wait. And I think get her on the opening credits. Jason Herbison, get her on the opening credits.
Even if it's Clive status, kind of recurring, permanent guest, star, whatever, we just want that reassurance that we're committed, the show's committed. We want her in the opening titles.
Yeah, I'm committed to Melanie.
We're both taking a vow today and committing to Melanie.
Really?
So guys, get on our hashtag train. Hashtag Melanie for regular.
Hashtag Melanie for regular.
I know exactly what I have to do.
Let's make it happen.
Did you know I once spent a summer on an alpaca farm?